Yeah, so similar to last week, average farm cover is coming in around 7.74 on average. The growth is 11. We've a good bit of grass there, but the demand is high. So if you look at the difference between the growth and demand, there is a deficit there. So farm covers will drop, and that's what we're trying to get the message out, that there's a lot of farms has been grazed, and we really need to focus on average farm cover. So percentage graze for this week should be around 50%. That's where you should be to meet your 2/3 of the farm grazed by Patrick's Day. A lot of farms are getting close to that 60% already this week. So, and farm covers, the opening farm covers were lower than normal. So therefore that's leading to a situation where farms are running tight. Okay, and 1 in 3 farms, George, I said, were on the edge last week, and that's still the same case this week. Okay, and growth, I suppose, isn't helping that at the minute. You can see predicted growth for the next week. Grass growth predictions getting up as high as 20, but that was Elodie, who produces these, said the weather was very variable on Tuesday. It was very hard to predict what was happening, so we're probably going to be back in the teens, maybe the low teens or something like that, given it's snowing outside today. But it is a perfect opportunity actually for guys who are well ahead of target to actually slow down, to slow down and actually let the farm cover hold it where it is. So the target should be to hold that farm cover above 600 until early April, until you're starting that second rotation. How you do that? You match growth with demand. So if the growth this week was 15 and you're stocked at 2.5 into 15 is 6 kilos, you feed 6 kilos of grass per cow, and then you supplement the rest in. Okay, dry matter is still good, ground conditions are still good given today. Over the next few days now, we are going to get more rain, but utilization is still pretty good. We want to, a lot of farms got fertilizer slurry out maybe around a month ago as well, so they should be looking next week where to go maybe with some fertilizer slurry to keep that grass growing for the second rotation. And one big thing I didn't mention last week that's coming into the fore now is we need to start checking the regrowths on the first graze paddocks. So those paddocks that were grazed like early February, some of them have like 500, 600, 700 back on them already on farms, and it's great. Other farms that don't though, so we need to be checking that. So the top three paddocks today should have around 400 or 500 on it, if you want to have 1,100, 1,200 on that in early April, so you can start grazing that second rotation.